The political comic strip Doonesbury has a history of stirring up trouble. This week, the creator is at it again. The comic series is attacking the Texas sonogram abortion law, likening it to rape. Jen Kastner reports.
This week, the funnies don't have everyone laughing. The comic strip Doonesbury kicked off Monday with a six-day series slamming a new Texas law. It requires women seeking an abortion to get a sonogram 24 hours before the procedure. They can decide not to look at the images or listen to the heartbeat, but they must hear about the fetus's development. On Monday, the comic strip's creator, Gary Trudeau, depicts a pregnant woman asking for an abortion. In this frame here, a clinic employee says to her, "You'll need to fill out this form. Please take a seat in the shaming room." Throughout the week, the strip will eventually liken the ultrasound procedure to rape.
Now, if you're looking for the Doonesbury cartoon series this week in the Midland Reporter Telegram, you're not going to find it where you think to look, in the comics section.
The paper has placed the series at the bottom of the opinion section, and they're running an alternative series, not the controversial one. In fact, this week, papers around the country are also shifting gears. Some are choosing the alternative series, others are placing it in a different section of the paper, and a few are choosing to simply not run any Doonesbury comics. Locals we talked to said the series goes too far.
There are some things that are just way too serious and way too delicate to make fun of, and that's what I feel like that comic is doing.
That hits home to a lot of people, you know, and I just don't really think it's necessary. There's so many other things that he could write about.
Planned Parenthood in Midland would not take a position on the comic series, but they told us the sonogram law serves no true medical purpose.
Its only purpose is to shame and humiliate women who have made a very difficult decision to have an abortion.
The organization thinks the law and recent cut to the funding of several women's health services shows the state is behind the times.
They're not truly concerned about women's health based on their choices.
In Midland, Jen Kastner, News West 9.